Hi there, this is a guest video from Stefan0719 on the Flores Electronics channel, and today I want to show you something that's a kit from a radio, and it's made by the Maxitronics company, and it has various features. It says that you can use it or build it without soldering, and here's basically the package. One thing I noticed on the package is this sticker here, which looks like it's made somewhere in China. And there was also another sticker which I removed to show more of the cover, but I did not want to remove the sticker from the manufacturer so you can see it. Now let's have a look at the package. And you can see that it has different pictures. It looks kinda new, like it was made somewhere far after the year 2000. And let's have a look at the back. And they did me a favor, because usually when I make videos, you may notice, I put the parts and show them to you, but hey, they made it for me. So here you can see we have a ferret bar, a circuit board, some capacitors, resistors, and there is a message. I go back with the camera so you can see it. There are various messages. The big message, the first one, states that you should not mix old and new batteries, which is something I'm a little bit wondering about, because there is a 9-volt battery, so how should you mix batteries? The next thing says that the components are packed in small boxes or small foils, and you should throw away the foils, because if you have a young child, eventually it will swallow the foils, and this is not good. Also, it says that the parts that are shown here can vary, so you will get the parts with the same values, but they can optically look different, hence they are improving their quality. And yeah, I guess you can read it by yourself in this high resolution, and even there we go, made in China. But it does not mean it's bad, because sometimes people think stuff that's made in China is bad. But I've made lots of different experience. I've often had kits from China, and they were in really good quality, and on the other side even very, very cheap. So don't complain about that. This does not mean it's a bad quality, it only means it's made in China. In this video I want to show you the Maxitronics radio kit build and see how it works. So this is how the part, or better, how this device gets pulled out of the cardboard box. I just slided it out, and this is how it comes out. And you see there are lots of holes. So yeah, you will need a screwdriver, I assume, and also you will have to do lots of work before you can actually start with the experiments. Okay, let's have a further look what's inside this cardboard. This is the kit taken out of the other cardboard box. On top left, we have the main circuit board. Next to it we have the black and white manual, which is around 5 mm thick, so there seems to be a lot of stuff written into the thick manual. Below it, both in foils, is the ferret bar antenna and the electronic components. So this is what's inside the box. The parts got took out of the other plastic bag, and you can see on the top left you have the main receiver board. Next to it we have some, let's say passive parts like the headphone, the 9-volt battery clip, some wires. Next to it we have some springs for mounting the components. And next to it we have some components, capacitors, resistor and a transistor. Below that we have the main circuit board. You can mainly see it's a cardboard box. And there are some holes drilled in it, so we will need a screwdriver, because we will need the screwdriver to mount the components or the circuit board or the capacitor. I'm assuming this. And there is no screwdriver supplied. Okay, that's all parts that we are supplied with this kit. And in the next part I'm going to take out the sole components from their plastic bags. Here are the parts that were inside the plastic bags. On the top left we have the circuit board, then we have a transistor, 4 resistors, 4 capacitors, a tuning capacitor below it, 9-volt battery clip, some wires that were pre-uninsulated and pre-tinned, that's nice, some screws and nuts, more screws, the springs for a connection, then we have next to the springs and below that, we have 2 clips for the ferret bar antenna, a green wire, headphone and the ferret bar antenna itself. The 4 parts, green wire, clips and headphone, were hidden in another plastic bag that was hidden inside the cardboard box in one side space. So I found it and took it here. So these are now really all components that are inside this radio kit. Now let's have a look how to continue with this electronic radio kit. So the first thing that you make is you have to install these springs that are making contact to various parts of the board. To add these parts, these springs, you just push them through the holes and they will hold. So you just push them through the holes and they will hold. And I'm going to show you how it works. And then I continue and do all springs off camera. And then you will see how it looks like. So you just push it through the hole. Okay. So I've installed one and it already does hold really well. So this is how the spring gets installed. Just push it through the holes and then it will be all right. They also want you, if you push the spring through the hole, they want to take your pen and write down the number of the spring on the other side of the cardboard. So push in one spring, take a pen and write, for example, here number one on the other side of the cardboard. Okay, I will do all this stuff off camera and then I'll show you the result and how it looks. So I've installed all springs and I've written the numbers on the other side of the circuit board or of the cardboard box. But there are two springs missing and I can't find them. I did look in the boxes, in the foil. I did look inside there, but I could not find them. I just could not figure out where they are. So two are missing on my kit. Probably I will pull out some of these and put them there. Depends on how I can make the wires. But it's very simple. It took me just a few minutes to put them all in. And they are really holding very well. So I can pick up the complete kit with one of these springs. They hold in place really well. On the other side, you can see I've written down the numbers as they want you to do. And yeah, that's pretty much about it. Okay, this is the kit with some springs installed, but two springs are missing on my kit. So this is the radio kit with the components installed. As you can see, I've installed the resistors and capacitors and the transistor at the same time, because usually in my videos, if you know them, you might have noticed that I usually show how to install the resistor, how to install the capacitor, but since this is not a circuit board which needs to be soldered, it doesn't matter if you first install the capacitor or resistor, although the manual instructs you to install the resistors, then install the capacitors, and the last part that needs to be installed is the transistor. Okay, I installed all components, and how you install is very simple. You just bend the wires, push them through the cardboard, or through the holes, then you bend the wires on the side, for example on this resistor, and there are these springs, and you then go ahead and you can see, if I bend them, they open up. And then you just slide the wire inside the spring and release it, and it will hold the wire very tight. The problem is that these springs are very hard to pull them apart, or pull them so you can install the parts. So I added a crocodile clip. I used the crocodile clip to get them and pull them apart, but on the other side, if they are having that much strength, the good thing is you will sure have a good contact and won't have a bad contact, and the circuit will work very reliable. Okay, still they are missing these two springs. Maybe I will find them. If not, I will have to find a way to get this whole radio kit working. So these are the springs now installed in the radio kit. So this is the backside from these contacts, from the springs, and you can see how it's mounted. It's not really pretty, but doing this, I'm really in a hurry. I can see there are some short circuits from the wires, but before I will power this, I will ensure that these short circuits are put away. Okay, so this is the backside from this radio kit. Thanks for this part, or better, in the next part, I'm going to look what the manual wants me to do, and I'm going to show you what is the next thing that you do. So first you install the resistors, then the capacitors, and then the transistor. Okay. So here are the components installed. If you know my videos, you know I'm first going to install the resistor, install the capacitor, but this is not a circuit board that needs to be put aside or turned around and then be soldered, so it doesn't matter which component you install first. So I went as the manual wants me to install the components. I installed the resistors first, then the capacitors, and then the transistor. Okay, so how does this work? Well, it's fairly simple. You just go ahead, put the components inside the circuit board. There are holes already pre-made. And then you have these springs. You bend one wire on this side and bend the other wire on that side. And then you push the spring and you can see it opens up. And then you slide the wire inside the gap that is in the spring, and then release the spring and it will hold really well. So this is pretty much how you install it on all sides. So one spring, you open it up, As you can see, it opens up, then you slide in the wire in the spring, and then you release it and it will hold. So these are all components, and still I'm missing these two springs. Eventually I will get a problem with that, but I'll sure find a solution. Okay, so this is all installed. So here you can see the back. So here is the back of this board. You can see that the parts, the wires, are inside the springs. There's a short circuit, there is a short circuit. I will fix that, and if I fix that, I'm going ahead with the next thing the circuit, or rather the manual, wants me to do. So these are how the springs work and how the wires are connected, or whether the connections from the parts are connected. Okay, let's see what's next. So this is the ferret bar antenna installed. The first thing that you do, you install these clips, then you turn it around. So these clips are like this in the board, then you turn them, or you can also turn them clockwise, and then they hold, and then you take away the second coil from the ferret bar antenna and leave the golden coil with the golden wire, or the copper-like wire, and then you slide the antenna bar through these holes. The wire goes through these holes and is connected to these two springs, as I showed you before how it's connected, and this is pretty much all you need to do. They could have added another holder here, because here it's a little bit shaky, but it does hold quite well for what it is. Okay, let's see what's the next thing that I need to do. Now I've installed the circuit board, you can see it here, but I'm missing these two springs. So here it is. Now I've installed the tuning capacitor, as you can see here, and there is no frequency, it does not give you a frequency, it only goes from 0 to 10, so I guess you have to assume the frequency it's receiving. And it was not too hard to install. There are two screws holding the capacitor in place, and one is holding the knob in place. And on the other side, I don't want to turn it around too often, but on the other side the wires go to these pins here, which means VC, variable capacitor, and is pretty much about it. So I've built the circuit now, I've skipped some parts, I've installed the battery is below this AM radio writing. Furthermore, I've connected the circuit board on the back side of this radio kit. And I changed the wiring, for example this one, I think it should go somewhere here, but this is connected to the circuit board and so this connection here is working like it should. If you look closely, you may have noticed that the ferret bar antenna is a little bit moved. I did already test it and it works and it works not at the same time. On the headphone you can hear it, I even received the station, but the thing is, either I have built something wrong, which I'm not sure I did, or it needs some improvement. Anyhow, I connect a speaker to it, which is laying outside of the picture, but you can hear it. I connect it, one goes there, one goes here, and the other one goes there. And you can hear that there is some static. And here can align the frequency. Hier kann ich die Frequenz einstellen. Schauen wir mal. Let's look. Aha. Listen. Listen, the humming. Sorry for the shaking, but the tablet is heavy. Now it's transmitting. Listen. You can hear it's oscillating. And if I put it back and touch it, it will regenerate. What I can do now, I now can connect an antenna. There's an antenna supplied. It's a few meters long wire. It's a few meters long. I connect it. So now I've connected the antenna. Let's increase the volume. So with the antenna, it's already oscillating from by itself. Listen. So it's oscillating. This is not super regenerative mode. It's a transmitter now. So you can think this is because I connected the speaker, but it's not because I connected the speaker. It also does it with the headphone. Maybe it's because on the picture there is another coil and I did not connect it. I will try that. So now I've connected the second coil, which gives me higher frequency reception. This coil now is not connected to the circuit anymore. So, for example, this was the first coil that was connected, this one here. And now the second coil is connected, this one here, which is not on the ferret staff. Okay, now we can receive 12 to 18 megahertz, at least that's what the manual says. I have once again connected my loudspeaker to the output so you can hear what this receiver is picking up. Let's turn it on. Around here, with the other coil, it stops oscillating. And around here, with the other coil, the super regenerative mode stops and it becomes a transmitter. Let's look if we can receive something. There is one station. There is another station. And that's pretty much about it. Now you can see with the different coil the circuit actually is working as it should. Maybe I will check my wiring, but I'm sure with the first coil eventually the design is not that good. I don't know, I will check it out and see if I can get it to work. So my review of this kit. This kit is alright for the price, but two springs are missing and the 49 meter coil does not work in my case. The headphone does sound okay, though it feels cheap, and this wire here is you can see it if I bend it, it stays like that, so it's not a flexible wire and this makes it kind of uncomfortable. So you move and the headphone falls out of your head. It just took me a few hours to build a complete kit. The manual is very thick and very well explaining its stuff about how to build it and maybe even other stuff. And yeah, that's pretty much the kit. As you can see, it's working. And I recommend it because what I like about it is that they show the schematic, and I admit that I have not read the complete manual since I'm really in a hurry making this video. But I'm sure they will explain it because the manual is really thick and just a few pages are how to build it. And I guess the other pages are how the stuff works and how about shortwave. Now I've built the radio. I've taken out from the video, I've taken out some steps where I built it. For example, installing the 9 volt battery and other stuff. Oops, it's a little bit wet. Well, and meanwhile I was also having a haircut, so this is like the part of it. So here I have the kit, and I have now connected this coil. This coil is not connected, and it's now 6 to 8 megahertz. And here is the tuning dial, and as you can see, I've hooked up my speaker already, and it's working. So let me turn up the volume. You can hear it's working, it's producing static. And if I turn here, it will go transmit. So, see, if I touch, it's super regenerative, as it should be. But if I tune here, it will go into transmit mode. That's with the 6 to 8 megahertz coil. And I don't know if I have made a mistake in building this, or if there is a mistake in the schematic already. I don't know it, but yeah, so that's pretty much how it works. There's an antenna wire. It has a length of a few meters, maybe 3 or 4 meters, but if I hook it up, which is really loud, it will only make it worse. Not working too good with this frequency range. Okay. So now I've hooked up the other coil. So this coil from 6 to 8 MHz now is disconnected, and this coil from 12 to 18 MHz now is connected. As you can see, I was lazy and I was just putting the wire up there because doing it like that I can switch from 6 to 8 or from 12 to 18 MHz. So I need just to take out the wire, put it in the middle, and this coil will be activated, which is 6 to 8 megahertz, or I put it on the right side, and this coil will be activated, which is 12 to 18 megahertz. Okay, so I'll increase the volume, and then we can have a listen if we receive a station. And we will see if there is a station being received. Also, I will hook up the antenna and see if it works better here. Now turn up the volume from my speaker. Okay, I can... Okay. So this was about the position. With this coil, about this position, it stops to receive, but now it's working. There is a station. The hum is coming from the loudspeaker, so with the headphone there is no hum. What's there? Empty carrier. So there must be some kind of carrier. Okay. That's with antenna. So now I've connected my speaker and the antenna, this green wire is the antenna, and there is lots of interference going on in this thing. So we have lots of interference there. Now let's see how it sounds with the speaker. So with the antenna, it's more sensitive but less selective, and external sources like the speaker, which is connected to the mains, make buzzing noises. So you may wonder why this headphone is disconnected and it still works. Well, it will work. This is just the audio amplifier, so this circuit has no effect on this circuit. So this is a review of the radio kit, and I have to give it an average mark. In German, it would be mark 3. And in English or American, it would be Mark C. So it's Mark C, and Mark C is not really good or not really bad. What I like about this is this. What I like about the kit is the construction with the springs. The springs work really well. They hold the components in place and they make a great contact. But in my case, I did not get the circuit to work, the 49 meter band circuit. Maybe my battery was a little bit empty. It actually should have been full. I charged it before, and with the pre-charged battery that I charged before, it works, but on 49 meters it starts to oscillate. Maybe I could get it to work, but for this video I did not want to put much more effort into it. The headphone is sounding okay, feeling a little bit cheap, and the quality in the headphone is okay. It's not too silent and it's not too loud. You can clearly hear what is received. If you connect a ground, like I connected my speaker, you will get issues with humming and interference, so it best works connecting it and supplying it with a battery. It's having low current consumption, it will run hours with a 9-volt battery. One thing that bothers me though is I read the manual and it's explained in different languages how to build this device, but what is not done is there is no explanation how the circuit actually works. So yeah, you can build it, it will pick up stations, especially in the higher frequency range where it works reliable, but on lower frequencies it's performing rather bad, and I would not recommend it for lower frequencies. So yeah, this is the review. You can buy it, it will probably work, but you won't really learn a thing from this Super Regenerative Receiver Shortwave AM Radio Kit. Okay, thanks for watching my video. Best regards, Stefan.